Hello everyone and welcome to this video about my top 5 non-fiction science books. Here they are in no particular order. Today I'm going to give you a brief rundown and review of each book and talk to you about why I like it so much. You probably saw from the title of this video that I'm actually a physics graduate. So I studied physics at university and graduated about, 2013 now, so a little while ago now, and I absolutely loved my degree. I thought it was so fascinating and so interesting, and I've always really been interested in science, and it just sparked this absolute wonder and awe for life and the universe and Earth and everything that it all encompasses. But after my degree, I decided that science wasn't a career that I wanted to pursue. So in order to keep my passion for science alive, I started reading non-fiction science books. And I now have a collection of about over 20, I'd say, and these 5 are my favorites. So we're going to talk about these today. Now, I want to clarify something before we get into the reviews. You may be wondering whether you need a science degree in order to enjoy these books. And the answer is absolutely not. These books were written for everyone. And one of the reasons why I like them so much is because they are so accessible to everyone. Whether you're new to the field of science, whether you'd like to start learning about it, whether you've already got a PhD in a field of science, it doesn't matter. And everyone in between will enjoy these books. They're written in a way that is very accessible and palatable and enjoyable for everyone, no matter how familiar you are with science. And that's what I love about these books so much. So with that said, let's get started. The first book that I'd like to talk about today is Physics of the Impossible by Michio Kaku. Michio Kaku is a physicist that I've actually seen on SBS a few times, and this book, Physics of the Impossible, is written about all the things that, as of today, are impossible. Let me give you a couple of examples. Things like force fields, invisibility, phases and Death Stars, telepathy, starships, extraterrestrials and UFOs, time travel and parallel universes, and a few other topics as well. He talks about all those things in this book and basically breaks down why they are impossible by today's scientific standards, why they could potentially be possible in the future, or if they're very, very unlikely to be possible, why that is. And he breaks up the different phenomena, I guess, or things that would be potentially impossible into 3 different classes. Class 1 are things that today are impossible, but could potentially, with ongoing advances in technology, be possible in the near-ish future. Class 2 are things that are probably going to be impossible for a little while, but could potentially become possible. And class 3 are things that are probably going to stay impossible forever. And there's only 2 items in class 3, perpetual motion machines and precognition. I found this book simply fascinating. I think it talks about a lot of things that you don't really learn about in other non-fiction science books, and I think it would be really interesting for someone who's also particularly interested in sci-fi, because it's really got that element of what if and is this possible and starships and UFOs and a lot of different categories that definitely overlap with sci-fi as well. I also really like how easy this book is to read. Even though a lot of the topics are quite technical and can potentially be very difficult to understand, I feel like Michio writes about them in a way that is easy to understand and he explains them in a way that is easy for everyone, no matter what their background in science is, to understand. So I enjoy that about this book too. If you're interested in picking up this book or any of the other books that I talk about today, I'll have links to them on Amazon in the description box below. The next book I want to talk about today is A Short History of Nearly Everything by Bill Bryson. Bill Bryson has a number of books. I don't think all of them are science-based. In fact, I think maybe this is his only science-based book. I'm not sure if he is a scientist, but he is a well-known author. And this book is basically about a whole bunch of interesting stories that have happened in the field of science, along with a history of the Earth and the universe and basically a little bit of everything in this book, as the title says. I like this book particularly because it's quite anecdotal. Bill Bryson puts in a lot of funny stories about things that happen to scientists and mishaps and I guess everything that comes with the world of science and experimentation, as well as talking about the history of the universe in a really interesting and, I think, anecdotal is the correct word. It's almost like he's just telling a story instead of recounting a whole bunch of facts. So I feel like this book is very entertaining as well as informative, and that's why I really like it. The third book today is For the Love of Physics by Walter Lewin. This book, I love it so much. I actually just chose it because I saw it in my local bookshop and thought it looked interesting. Walter Lewin is a professor of physics at MIT, and he's been lecturing on physics, for the last 40 years or so at MIT. And he's actually got a lot of videos on YouTube just about his lectures and what he talks about. And I'll link some videos in the description box as well. I believe he's a professor on YouTube that has a lot of videos of drawing straight lines on a chalkboard, like it's so entertaining to watch. I'll link some videos below, you have to see it. And so Walter also wrote a book. I'm not sure if he's written other books, but he's definitely written at least this book, obviously. And I just found it so fascinating. He talks a lot about his family history as well. And he speaks about it in a very real and raw and emotional way, which I found very interesting. But in addition to that, he also talks about a lot of physical phenomena that are just fascinating and you don't really learn about in other non-fiction science books. For example, how rainbows work. I never knew how rainbows worked until I read this book. Walter explains it in such an interesting and captivating way, and he really inspires awe in the reader and just a sheer appreciation for the world around us. He also talks about some of the experiments that he's done throughout his career and his contributions to the field of science and a little bit about the universe as well. Overall, I found this to be just a really heartwarming book. And I never thought that I'd say that about a non-fiction science book, but there you go. This book is simply heartwarming. And you can really tell how curious and how in awe Walter is of the world around him, and that is definitely infectious. And by the end of this book, you can't help but feel the same curiosity and awe that Walter feels as well. Next is someone that, of course, I cannot at all leave out of this video. It's a book by Carl Sagan. This one's Billions and Billions. I've read pretty much every one of Carl Sagan's books, and I adore him. I absolutely adore him. His zest for life and knowledge and the wonders of the universe is just absolutely palpable, and this book is no exception. My other favorite book by Carl Sagan is The Pale Blue Dot. I highly recommend reading that one too. Unfortunately, I don't have it with me at the moment. I actually borrowed that one from a friend and had to return it afterwards. But Billions and Billions is another really interesting, just also heartwarming book. Billions and Billions is actually the last book that Carl ever wrote. He passed away, I think, just after it was completed. And so the last chapter was written by his wife, just sort of, I guess, completing the book and talking about Carl's journey with his illness. And, oh, I almost cried at the end. I didn't expect to get such a personal story at the end of this book as well. In addition, Carl talks about a lot of other, I guess, things in this book, some about the universe, some about the cosmos, and some about important social issues as well. Carl was very interested in talking about not only science and the field of science, but also important things that humans need to know. And this book, I think, is a nice combination of both of those things. So if you're looking for a Carl Sagan book to start off with, Billions and Billions is an excellent one, or The Pale Blue Dot as well. And finally, I think my favorite non-fiction science book of all time, at least from the ones that I've read so far, is The Forces of Nature by Brian Cox. Brian Cox, in my opinion, is a modern day Carl Sagan. I also, I love him so much as well. I think that he has such a special talent in sharing science with his audience just as much as Carl Sagan did. And I think that he makes science incredibly interesting, incredibly captivating, no matter what your current background in science is. And this book is, I think, the epitome of how he inspires awe and wonder in those that read about science. The Forces of Nature talks about phenomena in the universe and on Earth, but it talks about things that I've never learned about before in non-fiction science books. For example, things like the tides, things like why bees create little hexagonal shapes in their honeycombs, talks about snowflakes as well and how they form their unique shapes, and just all these little things that you kind of just take for granted being a human on Earth, but you never really think about until it's put in front of you in a book. And I feel like the way that he explains these phenomena and the forces behind them is just so, again, it's awe-inspiring. I think all these books, all five of these books, if you could sum them up in one word, they are awe-inspiring. And this one I think is my favorite out of every single nonfiction science book that I've read. So there you have it, my top five nonfiction science books. I hope that this video has inspired you to get into science if you're not already reading about science, or if it has, it's helped you find some new books that you might want to read to learn, oh my god, I'm fly, to learn even more about science. I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you again very soon. Bye.